What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the N64 Chronicles. We are hitting our 10th game this week, and it's one that everybody knows and everybody loves, and I don't need to say a goddamn word. Let's just fucking play Mario Kart. So, like I said in the intro, there's just, this game is already great. This is actually the same exact cartridge I had as a kid. So this cartridge has been in my possession for 20 years now. I've played every track numerous times. I like going with Toad. Just even though he gets knocked around a lot easier, he gets the extra speed, or he's supposed to at least because of how small he is. So I'm going to attempt to get through each of the four cups, but I'll kind of play it by ear and see how long it takes me. See if I can remember this whole quick start thing too. Alright, apparently I got it. The one thing I hate about going backwards in this game series, because obviously I've played the newer ones as well, is the drifting in this one is a lot different than the newer games. Because in the newer ones you get like the speed boost depending on how long you hold onto it for. Which you don't get in this one. I mean, it's not the worst thing in the world, but It's difficult to get used to once, you know, you kind of get into a rhythm with the newer games. Hopefully I don't get hit by my own shell. I'm only getting green shell so far. Never took Yoshi out with me. Oh, okay, we're good. Almost hit the banana. Maybe I'll get something different this time. I would have preferred the green shells, honestly. I'll make him spit out, I don't care. Come on, you should get out of that anyway. Keep that up as a little shield. Race right off the bat, make this a little bit easier for myself. Aw, you piece of shit. Fucking Wario. It's always Wario, isn't it? It's cool going back to this one too, because a lot of these tracks have been remade in the newer games. So it's cool to see them, how they originally were done. Let's see if I can get this drifting to work for me. Because that's the thing with the first cup. You don't need the drifting to make it through. And again, with it not having the speed boost that the newer games have, it's kind of not really pointless. I mean, it helps you get through the corners faster, but not nothing added afterwards. Lap 2. Oh, I hit the brake. Well, take third. I don't know, I might not be winning this first cup, especially if Wario keeps winning the races. Now, this game will never get old, though. This was the pinnacle of every single era of my life that focused around gaming. Didn't matter if I was a kid or in college or now as, you know, adulting, but this thing's always, you know, that one game that always sticks out. The beach, goddammit. See, that's the negative side of Toad. I can never remember which of these two paths is supposed to be easier. I think I always end up taking the outside beach route anyways, but... Can I get a mushroom? Nope. Okay, well, I'll take the blue shell. Let's see if this helps me out anymore. Alright, I like being a threat in first place with the lightning bolt, I can take that right now. Shortcut through the beach. Come on, there we go. It's not very often you get to hold the lead with a lightning bolt. Oh, god damn it. I'll take it. Make sure I get the win. Fine by me. See how I did in the standings after that one. I am pretty sure I cannot beat Wario. He needs to finish like dead last and I need to win. That's what that's looking like. The Calamari Desert. Good little train track. Forgot how shitty the brakes are in this game. Like, they're almost non-working. take Yoshi out of the factor right now. What else can we get? Who the hell? How was Luigi in front of me? Did he use the fucking... He cheated. That piece of shit. He used the fucking train track cheat. Little asshole. Can't remember, but I think fourth place only gets like a single point, so this might be doable still. I'm just gonna go for the win, hope for the best. That's fine by me. Still in fourth. Come on. Oh, son of a bitch. Oh, watch, I'm gonna lose by a single point. Yep. A single point, all because of Luigi. Well, I'm gonna move on to the next cup anyways, just so I'm not doing the same one for the entire video. I guess we are watching the award ceremony, I forgot. It's hard-coded in. They just race. Yeah, second place. 1 point. Next cup would be... I'm gonna take Luigi for this one. Flower cup. Alright. So it's with this cup that everything starts getting a little bit more challenging, and you kind of need the drift if you want to get through the corners as fast as possible. This track in particular, you don't need it necessarily because the corners are huge, wide sweeping ones, and honestly, drifting through these things with all the traffic is not a smart move because you can't really control it if you end up drifting into a car. I've always felt like I had more of a chance of surviving that if I'm just turning normal through here. Jesus. Yeah. price. Oh, I don't think I'm winning this one. No, definitely not now. I can pass Toad and use this again. Alright, well, wiped out Mario. It wasn't really part of the plan, but the star is your best friend on this track. Understand how they got this big of a lead on this small of a track. Like, well, not small, but you know, it's a really straightforward track. There's no opportunities for shortcuts or anything like that. I'll take a second if I can hold on to it. Oh, where's that finish line? Let me see that finish line. The needle there. Alright, second place. One, Peach. Alright, apparently Peach is my enemy this round. This one's pretty fun. You get a little, like, a couple of areas with little snowman armies. Like that guy right there. There's at least one spot here in this track. I think it's next to, like, the gigantic snowman, where there's just, like, dozens of them scattered at the feet. Yeah, right here. Minefield going through here. They get free item. See? Nope. Alright, we're taking out Mario with it apparently. Not bad, that got me into second place. Well, the good news is, even if we don't win this one, Peach isn't even in the top four, so she's not getting any points. I would save the fucking banana. Slide right into the snowman. Alright, I'm not gonna fire any of these things off just yet. Well, I'm gonna take out DK. Just quickly give myself a little barrier going across. No. Give. Yes! Last second pass. Alright. Peach still. Oh wow, Peach finished way, way back. That's gonna help us. That's gonna put us in first place, I think. Yep. Got first place by 2 points right now. I used to hate this track as a kid. There is a section of it. Crap. I missed the quickfire because I got a text. No, there's a section where these giant boulders can come crashing down. And I'd always get hit by them. And then to top it off, the part up ahead where the track kind of loops around itself. And there's no protection. So if you fall down, you essentially go backwards on the track a little bit. And I think actually that portion of the track is the reason I try not to rely so much on the drift in this game anymore, because I'd always try to drift that corner and fall down. And it always happened to me on the last lap too, because that corner is like in the last section of the course. Crap, not what I wanted to do. These boulders right here. And then this is the part right here that's not protected, that if you fall down, you essentially repeat that last turn. No! Stupid mystery box. Really? I'm last place. That right there. Well, I guess it doesn't really matter. Take him last place. I don't even... At least it... No? It didn't even put me on the upper part where I actually fell from? And I'm getting lapped by fucking Toad. Because why not? Why not incur a little bit more death? Maybe I can just get lapped by the entire crew. Oh, I get to retry. Why, thank you. I got screwed on that one. There's that quick start that I was looking for. You out. I wouldn't mind taking Bowser out, but I don't think I can get to him in time. And I'd rather ensure that I can stay on the track. To take down Bowser right now. Come on, give me the lightning bolt or something stupid. Yeah. like a red shell. Really? I was hoping for some help from that. Alright. Fingers crossed that I don't... Never mind. Never mind. Well, I have resigned to the fact that I'm not going to win this cup either. So, I'm just gonna finish this one off. And then move on to the next one. Maybe I can win one of the championships. Alright, so it looks like if I want to win this one, Bowser has to finish outside of the top four, and I need to win. Or no, I can win and he can get second. Fingers crossed, guys. Here we go. Moment of truth. Just missed the box. Fuck Christ, Bowser. That was some bullshit. Yeah, I definitely am now. After that chain of slaps at the end. So we get another chance to take down Bowser. That's always good. Because I think you get the retry chance if you finish 5th or worst. Which makes sense, because then you don't get any points. Second time's charm. Might be redoing this one a third time. Keeps going like this. Back to back bolts. I must be doing that bad in the game's eye. Come on. something. Nope. Well, that might actually help me, so. I was gonna try to fucking pull an e-brake and finish fifth and get another retry, but whatever. Maybe with the third cup. We got third place still. So I'm just gonna edit out this ceremony. You don't need to watch it again for me to get a worse trophy. Alright, cup number three. Let's try Mario. This is gonna be fun. This one we need the drift. And as clearly evidenced, I still have not remastered it. So for some reason this track is always my favorite one in this game. I don't know why, there's nothing crazy about it, it's just an indoor, you know, supercross track, really. But I've just always liked it for that reason. I'm pretty sure, I think I remember something, reading something recently. That said, that this track is one of only two tracks from this game, I believe, that haven't been remade in the later games, which I feel like they haven't remade it because of how simple it is, but again, to me, that's one of the great things about it. You know, because out of all the courses, pretty much this one, and then the Mario and Luigi circuits that are the most, you know, realistic, I guess you could say. Oh, I thought I was gonna get screwed. Tried to cut that corner way too much. Lap number two. Supposed to be a cheat on this one too, that I remember spending hours as a kid trying to pull off, that involves that first huge hill, jumping off of it, this little pre-drift jump that you can do, and apparently if you jump off of it at the right spot and hit the button at the right time, it can send you over the wall and essentially cut off like a quarter of the track. And again, I spent hours upon hours as a kid trying to pull it off and it never worked. So maybe I'll have to stream this one on Twitch when I'm done and just keep replaying Wario Stadium and try to pull that one off. Because it would just be cool to finally get that done after 20 years. Nope. Of course, I'm gonna spin out. Come on, guys. Second, there's Toad with the lead. Yeah, this jump right here, apparently you can jump off of it and sail over that wall. Shit, I forgot I had to back. long as I can still see Toad, hope is not gone. I'm gonna hold on to this star for a little bit. Oh my god, are we gonna start off with a win? We are starting off with a win. Toad almost stole that shit. Alright, this one's looking more promising for me. This is one of the more annoying tracks. You're not only dealing with those little penguins darting around, but you know, those little ice shelves that chop off. And then when I was a kid, I used to get extremely lost in this section up ahead. If I can actually make it to this section up ahead. I mean, now it's not so bad, but again, 8 years old, I think the first time I ever played this track, I made like 6 laps inside of that cave by itself. Looks like it was Wario that dropped the bullet. Ah, stupid penguins. Understand how I just spun it. I feel like that one is so random. Like, it makes sense, obviously, when you go over the banana, but... Alright, you piece of shit, Wario, get back here. Never mind. You took care of yourself well. Well, if I can get around Luigi, then me and Toad should end up being tied in the standings. Nope, not gonna happen. Ah, had it. Get off the wall. Take it. Again, I don't remember if... Oh, I think I got the retry. Yeah, okay, so it is 5th. I couldn't remember if it was definitely 5th or if you had to finish dead last. Too far over. That was my fault. It's so picky about when you can start hitting the gas again when Lakito brings you back to the track. Right down the middle. Hmm. Damn it. I guess I just don't want to go past this track. Missed where I am. Ah, 3 for 3. And now it's gonna fall too. Well, I think we're retrying this one more time. Not that I want to. I've mentally given up on this one. Because we have to do this one more time anyways, so... whatever. Let's just do this. Attempt number 3. Okay, never mind. He took himself out for me. Go around this way, in here, around the outside, and turn right. Shit. Come on. Last lap, everyone's still right there. We can do this. Yes! No! So close. But again, I think that officially ties me and Toad up. It has me technically in the lead. Okay. this one's another fun one. I don't know, I've never been a huge fan of this one, just because the only really cool thing about it is the big jump ramp, and it's not even all that spectacular. I mean, the one we just came from is different, and then the one after this, Bowser's Castle, you know, they're classic tracks, and then this one always gets pulled back. I think it's, this one's been remade at least once or twice. I don't really see the big draw about it. It's not a horrible track, but again, it's nothing incredible, and that corner always gets me. Toad's right in front of me now, so that's a good thing. Well, now Bowser is. Alright, all the way he's gone. Don't hit the mountain side. Give me something good. Take a second. Only cuts me 3 points out of the lead. Alright, let's wrap this up with Bowser's Castle, and then I'll probably come back on my own on a separate day and capture the last cup for this video, so I'll make sure, hopefully, to get it in before Monday. Also depends on how many times I get stuck up on this one. Yep. I was just about to say that I always used to get stuck by the womp blocks as a kid. Clearly that is still relevant. These two. It's been so long since I played this track that I know I'm gonna have to read it at least once. What the fuck was that shit? Really? Really? Oh, that was bogus. Hopefully I can make something happen. Probably not, though. Gotta pass at least two more people. Okay. No. Get by one more person. Nope. Not after that. Well, we're gonna be redoing this one more time, apparently. Unless. Nope. Alright, one more. Which, again, I'm somewhat fine with because it gives me a chance to actually win the cup. I've always wondered why this one doesn't get included in the final of the Star Cup. Because this track's pretty hard, at least in my opinion. I can't remember off the top of my head what's in the Star Cup. But I know there's one of them that I've always felt was easier than this one. No, no, off the bridge. That's not good. Come on, really? I've never seen that happen before. I've never seen those things explode like that. And again, off the side. Apparently this game just doesn't want me to stop playing it. Honestly, I don't even care about winning anymore. I've resigned to the fact that I'm not winning this cup, so right now I just want to get past Peach. I don't even think it's doable anymore. Eh, she's right up there. I guess depending on what happens over here. Nope. One more round around. Alright, so I think now what I'm gonna do is this is gonna be my last attempt, period. And then I will come back in a separate video, kind of like a part two, and that's where I'll do the Star Cup. Just because I don't want to drag this out and make this episode too long. When I started it, I kind of wanted to keep all the episodes at no more than an hour. And I have to be over the hour at this point. But we will find out. Who knows, maybe I'll go to edit this thing tonight and I know it's not taking me that long. Really? The stupidest stuff. And I hate that it sets you so far back, like, I fell off, just be nice and put me on the other side. Please. I think that's always been my biggest complaint about this game, is Lakitu's little drop-off points. Sometimes don't make sense. Sweep out left. Really? I'm gonna finish dead last. Come on. Yep, dead last. Alright, well, I'm going to crawl across the finish line, and that'll be it for the gameplay portion of this video. I apologize for all the repeats. Apparently I can't handle the 150cc anymore though. So that's going to do it. That is the first three cups in Mario Kart 64. And again, I will definitely come back and capture the last cup, at least an attempt at the last cup, and put it up as its own separate video. But for now, let's talk a little bit about Mario Kart and see what the Bible has to say. Alright, boys and girls, so as usual, before I say what I want to say about this game, let's see what the good book's got to say. So I guess right off the bat, there was some negative feedback about this game simply because there were less tracks than the Super Nintendo version, but I've played a little bit of the Super Nintendo version, and if I can remember correctly, there are more track variations, but there's less locations. Which, I'm a fan of the fact that there's more locations in this one, because you could do the same location with a dozen different tracks, but you'd still be looking at the same stuff in the background, whereas this gives you a whole bunch of stuff to look at. But it does praise, you know, the 3D effect, the multiplayer battle modes and all that stuff, which I can attest to are a ton of fun. Honestly, despite all the newer versions and the newer features, and I apologize that I keep going in this silhouette, I blame TV. But no, despite all the newer versions and the newer graphics and everything, I still think this is my favorite in the series so far. Because everything else just kind of expands or tries to become what this was. And this one, as far as Mario Kart goes, is just perfect. So, if you don't have this in your Nintendo 64 collection, you need at least this in your Nintendo 64 collection. So, that is going to do it for this episode. Next week, possibly even earlier, depending on what's going on, let me get to this one a little bit sooner. We have Blast Corps coming up next, which I believe is a fighting game. I've never owned it, never played it before, so I don't know. It's going to be a new dipping in the waters one for me. So, we'll be playing this next time, so come check it out. And stay tuned for more on the Honest Gamer Channel. Game on, guys.